Most of our mornings, or most of my mornings, they really start out in the field. Most of the activity all the activity is out on the job site. So I go out there in the morning and spend some time out there with the guys and you know, just do our safety checks and walks and just, you know, show my presence around, make sure that everything's running good. Today the weather's a little bit not cooperating with us a little bit. It's raining, so we're here in the office first thing. And typically when I come into the office, I check my emails, go through my email and look through it and respond to some of the emails. I go on and look at my HESS safety manager's page here, our dashboard. This really helps me look at what's coming up and what needs to be done, and we kind of lined out our training, our core training, our yearly training, and it really helps us out with that. So that's kind of what I do here in the morning. This is our gearbox, where I have all the PPE that the guys need on the job site. Replace these, are extra large. Here's the different types of gloves that we have for the guys. We have these nitrile black palm, very flexible gloves that these guys like to use. We have the leather gloves for the guys, and then these chemical gloves for, like I said, for the chemicals. When they're using with concrete or anything like that, they'll use these. And then most of the guys like the good old leather work gloves that we have. We also stock up, you know, one of our policies to wear the face shield when they're working out there. And so I got to make sure that they have the brackets. I want to make sure that we have face shields out here for the guys. So I just keep everything stocked as we go. Sometimes I run out and I just have to restock and just keep everything fresh, I guess. We're fully stocked. This is what a safety man's toolbox looks like, I guess, with all this stuff in here. So ready to go. Load it up. Let's roll. So today we are going to be heading down to Tucson to go visit a couple of our job sites, depending on the weather. But we have guys down there that are doing a reline project, basically rehabbing existing water lines. So we're going to go out there today and spend some time with those guys and make sure everything's okay with them and kind of do a safety inspection, talk to the superintendents and foremen, and just make sure that things are running smooth. And typically on a day that I go to Tucson, it's close to 200 miles away or so, depends on where we're at in the valley, but I make it a full day or spend most of the day out there. You know, I'm not gonna drive an hour to 2 hours just to go there for a short period of time. So I try to spend the time up there, you know, and try to get out to the Tucson area at least once a week. Twice a week if possible. You know, with when we're really, really busy, it's really hard to manage that, but we try to get through it and get there. Want to make sure that you know, we have gas, and because we travel quite a bit throughout the valley, and the last thing I want is calling our mechanics to come and fill me up because I ran out of gas. That wouldn't be a good thing. The guys will be making a lot of fun of me if I did that. I know our equipment manager, Mark, will. So, all right. So on long routes when I'm driving, I'm always listening to the radio. I like music, and I listen to Mexican music just because I like it. And you know, I do listen to some of the English music too, but most of the time it's gonna be Spanish. I think it helps me with me staying bilingual. So I like it. Call Omar Smith.
Calling Omar Smith.
What's up, Peter?
What's up, Omar? Hey, so what, are you guys working today or no?
A little bit, mostly cleanup.
Okay. What are you guys, well, depending on the weather, would depend on the weather for tomorrow, right? I mean, you guys...
Yeah, we're going to do some tie-ins, but it's probably going to be raining.
Okay.
I mean, I've been checking the weather, and it keeps dying back, and it's not going to fucking rain. Well, actually, it's a 70% chance right now for 8 a.m., and that's when my shutdown is.
Okay.
But I got to get them done, so...
All right.
Well, we're going to be out here in the rain.
Okay. Yeah, so I'll touch base with you in the morning, and okay. To let you know, see, we're going to head out there. And
all right, good, and I'll shave.
Okay, yeah, shave, look good, all that stuff. All right. Okay, thanks, Omar. Bye. Tengo familia allá, pues ahí en Mexicali. Vivimos unos tiempos también ahí en San Luis Río Colorado, Sonora. Ahí tengo unos tíos también en San Luis. Y... pero casi toda la familia de mi mamá y mi papá viven allá para Mexicali. When I kind of drive up to the job site, I kind of do a quick scan of the job and things that maybe look out of the ordinary, or maybe, you know, if we're working in an area where there's a lot of pedestrians or a lot of foot traffic, I may look at the area, like sidewalks, to make sure that we don't have any materials, tools, or anything like that might be in the area that can cause a trip hazard to the general public. Things like that, you know. I look at, you know, our guys working, making sure that they're in a safe position to be working, and make sure that they're looking at, that they're wearing the right equipment, and things like that. Just a quick overview, quick scan as I'm driving up to the job site. So here's our Tucson yard. And I think we're... First guy's here. We'll see here. What's going on there, Dan Broderick?
Not much today.
Yeah?
Just getting ready for another busy day.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. So we're out here going to go check out the guys over doing the reline, and Tino and his guys, make sure everything's all right. So just stopping by, checking up with you.
Great.
All right.
Good to see you.
Okay, take care. This is a, we call this a winch. They use this to... lower the guys into our manholes. This one's one that's been taken out of service, so I need to send it back to the shop and get it serviced. This indicator here shows that it was impacted, so that red mark tells us that this is no good. So I have to take this one back and send it to the manufacturer so they can fix it and recertify it so they can use it. So. it doesn't happen that often, but yeah, it does. You know, I think certain applications, it may get bound up a little bit, and that's what happens. I'm gonna leave this here for right now. Actually, I'll just take it out. Right now we're going to drive up to this job site. They're relining some of the water lines, and it's right on the mountainside. It's going to be a really nice project that we have going on. So it's going to take maybe 15 minutes to get there, but it's in a private community. I have to kind of drive up the mountain through the neighborhood and stuff like that. So it's actually really nice. It's a really nice project. Our Tucson office, that's basically their biggest scope of work down here, is that they have a contract with the county where they do a lot of the rehab and repairs and maintenance of the infrastructure. And so these guys are really busy. So as you can see, the truck in front of us, that's our superintendent. He's actually going to the same project where we're going. But he has that 800 number in the back, and that blue sticker. It's called Safety First Program. And what it is, it's a driving monitoring program. So we have a lot of trucks on the road every day, you know, and part of the training that we have is, you know, to be a courteous driver. But that number there is associated with this truck, and it's associated with them. With that particular driver. So if someone calls and says he's driving or cut him off or didn't use a blinker or whatever the case is, they'll call and put in a complaint, and I can talk to the driver and get his side of the story, maybe do some coaching with them. So that helps with our monitoring program on the driving behavior. So that's a good thing for us. We also get calls where they tell us, you know, it's you know, compliments. The driver was very courteous. He was driving the speed limit, you know, things like that. It's not always bad. So it's good. It's a good program. Safety is my goal, and that's really what our goal is for our company. But that is our driver monitoring program. It's kind of cool. So this particular neighborhood that we're going to, this is the area where all these houses have some crazy names. This one here is called Camino Sin Vacas. Means a walkway without cows. So we're on a walkway without cows right now. Camino sin pecado. Walkway without sin. That's another one. Qué beautiful, no? Mira qué bonito se mira. Yeah. It's complicated just for the simple fact that we have really tight areas. We have equipment, so we don't have a lot of room to maneuver. We have big trucks, big machines, and when we're working in tight areas, you know, it's really complicated just to get the equipment in and out. No.
It was going backwards.
Yeah?
That's fine.
How much traffic flow we're getting through here?
This is very easy.
Yeah.
In an hour, maybe one vehicle or less.
Okay, that's not bad. That's not bad.
Not at all.
That's good. Cool. Lydia, you have gear on?
No, that's what I asked you.
Came to ask the guy.
I left mine in my truck.
You're lucky I don't write you up, okay?
Whatever.
I don't know if I have a hard hat, actually. I don't know if I have a hard hat for her.
I think we have an extra one.
Okay, you're lucky, Lydia.
I'm in luck. I forgot mine in my truck.
See, they have an extra hard hat. And I even got...
medium best?
Did you bring a jacket?
Medium.
Medium,
I can't. Hey, take it easy. Take it easy. Let's go take a look. Yeah, it's nice, huh? It's not too bad. Come on, Lydia. I know. Yeah, you can smell it, huh? Yeah, yeah.
Keep that low.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Oh,
hey.
Nice.
What's up, Freddy?
Hey.
How are you, buddy? So what they're doing right now is, they'll tell me a little bit more of what the process is. I'm not sure where they're at right now. But they're doing confined space work when it comes down to safety, on the safety side. Before they went in here, they had to monitor the opening to make sure there wasn't any gases and things like that. And then they continue to monitor it throughout the day. They do a report. So they'll do this report here. This is the initial monitoring that was done. And then they did another one every 15 minutes, then every half hour. Depends on the activity that's going on. They'll continue monitoring it throughout the day, but then they'll start recording the time here. You know, and then they may pull that out for a little bit because there's no issue with the ventilation.
Right.
And then they'll just put it back in and let it flow. Yeah. The guy that's down in there, he's always going to be tied off to this here. And just in case something does happen, Freddie's able to actually move this directly over and retrieve them out of the manhole without him going in there. So that's a...
This is probably on the top five more dangerous things that we do, entering in confined space and gases.
Yeah.
This is an everyday occurrence for us.
There's a special gas that comes out of the sewer. It's called H2S2.
Oh, yeah.
And it'll kill you. It has a rotten egg smell, and if it gets too strong, it'll numb your senses. You can't smell it anymore.
Yeah.
And then he'll die, and then you'll go down there and get him, and you'll die. And that's why we have the retrieval system.
Where's your other monitor, the four-way monitor, the gas monitor?
It's on him.
Okay, so he has one, too, on him, and that monitor senses any issues with the atmosphere. You know, if there's issues with low oxygen or H2S or gases or anything that's gonna be flammable, it starts to beep, and that means they have to get out. So when that happens, they there's no questions, they have to come out. So they're monitoring to make sure that he's all right. He's recording stuff.
Are they gonna come in here?
No, they're just gonna put the camera there so he can kind of see. Right now they're prepping to push this light train through, and they're testing the lights to make sure that everything was running okay, and they're checking it on the monitor here. Gives us the amount of watts that they're using and make sure that everything's working right.
Okay, we're good.
That camera, that light train, has a camera on here, and then you can see it going into the manhole now.
You actually get a better shot from that one over there.
And that's the same one, so. And now this is being recorded.
All this is
being recorded as they're doing that. So that's the line. He's down in the bottom of the manhole. That's the line that we're gonna run it through. And this is all the liner material.
All right, stop. Have Milton, have him up, air up the bag. Have Milton air up the bag one more time.
Get as high as you can. So
this communication is very important between these guys.
Yeah, we get kind of the higher end walkie-talkies. Mm-hmm. If we can't hear or we're not communicating, we're ripping liners out. That's a lot of fun.
You're going to pull nice and easy,
Not only is it difficult, but it's more of a challenge when you try to pull it out too, right?
Oh, yeah.
I mean it's difficult either way, but that's
a lot of risk, a lot of obstacles. But when the liner, when he pays attention and he makes sure that the liner is aired up all the way when he's feeding in the light train, it goes. So good job, Freddie.
This job can be stressful right here.
Yeah.
This is probably the higher stress end,
really?
Because you have to QA, QC, and this is where we make all the decisions. The camera can play tricks on you.
This is where you second guess yourself. Oh, did I get a hole in the liner when I was pulling the light train?
Oh, yeah. And this is...
We came up to the end, and right when we got to the end, the rope cut a hole in the liner.
Oh, wow.
And it started... The air infiltrates that bag and pushes that resin out.
Right.
And we had to stop right there and trip.
Wow.
I mean, it was like, all right,
spot.
You guys get down there, you know, just...
Instead of losing...
Wow.
Good job, guys. Good job.
Now it's going to get busy for them.
Okay.
Now we're going to air up.
Now we can go down there now and take a look. Right now, we're just kind of doing a quick inspection on these things. To make sure that, you know, everything's functioning right, the clips are working right. These guys do it every day, but I just kind of come and do a quick look that the cables are not worn. Make sure everything's working. They get used every day, so it's important that we inspect them every day. You know, tags are missing on this one, so that's something that we got to look into and maybe replace it or get a new information on it. But this is a new one. It just gets tossed around a lot.
Do a safety meeting or a
tool box? No, do a go back where it says inspections.
Oh, okay.
Inspect, yeah. And there's one that says all go here, all. And then, yeah, that's fine. It's gonna load up right now, and then there's the one that's called, it's like a work zone safety or work zone, something like that. And this has like 10 of them.
Okay.
That's something that I do because it's quick and it just documents the inspection.
These have been added somewhat recently.
Yeah, there's some. Yeah.
I always look for them, and they're.
Sometimes it takes a while to update. If we don't refresh it every day. It takes a little bit, but once it's updated throughout the day, you're good. You're good to go. In areas where it's tight like this, we do close out the roadways. We just gotta coordinate with all these residents and make sure that we give them enough room to park and move through their neighborhood. And it's tough for us because we gotta park out in the streets, and that's another challenge or another obstacle that these residents have to deal with. But you know, some of them are good with us working here because they know it's an improvement. And some of them may get a little frustrated because we're disrupting their daily drive. But for the most part, it's good. You have your iPad with you? Okay. Well, we just want to. Yeah, that's good. No. We just want to make sure that we're doing an inspection. If they come out, they record. Yeah, when they come out, they might want you to do an inspection. You know, with the iPad.
Yeah, I mean, been in there to look.
So you go here. Yeah, let's let it load here real quick, and then we'll show you how to go about it that way, because. The paperwork, it's good to do the paper, but if we have it here, it's documented a lot quicker and we have it available, and we can, for me, if let's say we have an inspection that happens and OSHA comes out or something, and you say, yeah, we've been doing inspections and we do it every day. And they may say, can I get the inspection for like the last month? Well, yeah, we can give it to them the paperwork wise, but we have to look for some of them, and some of them may, you know what I mean? Yes. And here it's all there. I can just go up to my safety manager and look at the excavation permits and or inspections and job site, and from this date to this date, and everybody that did an inspection, they'll have the recorder, which is you or whoever did it, their name, and they'll have all that information on there, and I just print it out and hand it over. It's a lot easier. Okay, so now this is updated. You're on the right job, right?
No, it's not loaded in there yet.
Okay, so anyways, we'll just still leave it on there. So you go here where it says inspections. Okay. And go to where it says add inspections. And then you go excavation trenching, mm-hmm. Right there. And then you go utilities, located surfaces. It's 26 items, so you can go through that. You know, I would still do your daily one, because that's a quick one in the morning prior to you guys starting. And then maybe towards the end of the day or middle of the day, you would do something like this too. You know, so. Yeah, like right now. Yeah. Like right now, I mean, we have all the utilities have been located. Mm-hmm. Everything's all good. Yeah.
They have the gas company come in and cut out abandoned gas line in here.
Yeah.
Because, it turned there, but there was a dead one in there. We're not allowed to clip it ourselves.
Right,
so
right.
They got to come and terminate it. But the electric and the phones right here.
Okay. So, yeah, so we'll do, you know, utilities have been located.
It's for the wrong job.
That's all right. Sorry. I'm not going to save it, but I'm not going to save it right now, but I'm just going to kind of go with it with you. Yes, or if it's even if it's something that's not available or doesn't apply, you can always just put NA, and that doesn't work, right? It won't. NA traffic conditions, yes. NA excavation 20 feet, no NA, they're not 20 feet. Yes, we have the shoring or box or protection. No stable rock, no soil A, soil B.
That's nice.
Uh-huh.
It's nice, yeah, it's quick.
Class C. Any mixed soils? Well, yeah, I think there's a little bit of mixed soil, so I would do that. And they're protected from the loose rock. We have the plates, we have that, we have everything else, so you just do that. You know, it's just everything that we're looking at, it's all here, really, yeah. You know. Materials, yeah, there's no materials anywhere close within 2 feet, so we'll say it's good to go. Trench protected at least 18 inches above a vertical side. Yeah, you know, there's nothing that can roll in there and fall under and hit my man down there. Proper walkways. There's no need for a walkway, but there's a ladder and access. So you can check that off, yes. And workers protected from falling loads. Well, yeah. Ladders approved. Yes, that ladder looks good. It's tied off. It's extended above 3 feet, so everything's good on that ladder. All right, earth moving equipment, they all have the backup alarms and things like that. Wes, Chris was driving off and he backed up a little bit. You can hear it, you can see it. This just talks about excavation requirements, so we'll just mark it yes. Here at the end of the day, barricaded at the end of the day or at the work shift, yes, it's barricaded. Is there any water that has to be removed or is going to be removed? You just would add that here. Right now you just put NA because it doesn't apply. And daily inspection. So, you know, like when we come out here, some of the things that either just you and, what's the name again?
Willie.
And them, I mean, every day they come out, they're looking at the soil. So it's a visual. So we can always mark that down as daily soil inspection. Yes, we're doing that all the time. And then signalers when dump trucks are discharging, if it doesn't apply, it doesn't apply. We're not having that right now.
Tomorrow
we will. Overhead power lines is another thing. If we're going to be dumping, you'll see the overhead power lines. So right here, it's not a big deal, right? NA. NA. Testing controls, no, we don't need to do monitor. It's not a confined space. So I would say no on that one. And see where it says heavy equipment. You could say yes. And then let me show you something else too. Just this is it says 26 items, and there's other inspections that have a lot more sections. You're probably talking some of them may have like 130, but not all of them apply. So like if we're going through this one here and some sections like this particular section, let's say heavy equipment, that's something that didn't apply at all. we could just go like this, NA, and that actually collapses that section and it eliminates that part of the inspection. So you don't have to go through that section because it doesn't apply. So anyways.
I understand. Yeah, but tomorrow it will apply because the trucks will be dumping.
Right.
Putting material.
Yeah.
Cool.
So,
so how do I delete it?
Yeah, you can email it, you can do. So right now, yeah, don't, at the end of the day, so you can just go back, and that saves it, and then if you don't want to, yeah. There you go.
Because this job's not loaded yet.
Right. So, good. That's good, man.
Very good.
Good job, thank you, sir. You know, it looks like, you know, they're keeping the job clean and looks like they're doing their inspection as well. The guys are wearing their PPE okay. It was a good job. You know, like I said, all of our jobs, you know, I'm not going to say they're perfect because there's always going to be an issue here and there, but they're all, for the most part, they're just like that.
All right, so anyways, up here, still in the curing process. We get ready to cut the fiberglass liner. Actually, it sounds like they're cutting it right now.
Okay.
That's the end stage.
Cool. Let's take a look. Hey, real quick, I need to look at your site-specific safety plan. Did you guys do that this morning?
You have the site-specific fill out for the day?
Your site safety plan?
We talked about it, but you didn't fill it out?
Yeah. That's not good, huh? Remember, we talk about that every day. We got to make sure we're documenting our safety meetings.
I do it every day.
I know that you guys talk about it, but yeah. we gotta have it in writing too.
Have it in writing.
Okay, that's you guys. That's
we talked about it.
If
this
it's
morning.
If it's you know, you're gonna designate, it's okay that they do it because they know how to do it.
Mm-hmm.
But we want to make sure that we follow up and make sure that they're doing it.
Yeah.
Okay, because. No, pues tampoco a mí. You know, we do our planning every morning when we're talking about safety, and we have a it's called a site-specific safety plan. It's a documented safety plan. And so when I came out here, I was talking to the foreman. And as I come out, I do spot checks, and I asked him if he had it. And, you know, he had his lead man down in the bottom, and he asked him if he had it, and he didn't have it. They talked about it. They just got in a rush to get out here, and they didn't write it down. So, you know, I basically went back, and I told him that, you know, it's good that we're talking about it, but we also have to document it. So hopefully, I think these guys are pretty good. So when I tell them something, they correct it. I mean, sometimes, like I said, they slip. Everybody slips every once in a while. No one's perfect. So, you know, am I upset about it? A little bit. But I know it wasn't something intentional, and I know that it's not something that always happens with that crew. So we're good. They're gonna correct it. So next time I come out, they'll have one. So what they were doing right now is they're pulling this liner out with this roller, and we had one of our guys down in there just kind of guiding it, but there was no need for him to be down there. This roller does build up a lot of pressure, and as it starts to build up, there's a possibility of it getting caught, and then it snaps and it could pull something back out and hit him and strike him. So we don't want him in there when that's happening. You know, he just has to come out till they're done pulling. Then he can now go back in there and do his thing. So he has his monitor on. You know, the monitor's good. There's no issues. Right now we're doing continuous monitoring, and every so many minutes or so we do the air blower, just kind of circulate the air.
Dámelo.
¿Está todo bien el monitor ya?
Sí.
Okay. This morning we're going to a job out in Tempe. It's called the pedestrian project, a pedestrian improvement project. There's not much activity. Again, we've been having some pretty serious weather, But we're gonna go meet with our project superintendent, just kind of see how things are going on that end. And then close by there's another project separate to the one that we're going to. And they're doing a repair, an emergency repair for the city of Tempe. So we'll get to see some action going on with the weather. You know, there's other risks, other safety issues that we got to think about. So we're gonna look at those things today. Some of the hazards and challenges that we have when the weather's like this and it's wet, you know, we're working in trenches and excavation. So after a while with the weather, the soil gets saturated with the water and moisture, and it gets loose, and it could fall and give, and it can become very, very dangerous. An excavation can collapse pretty serious with this weather. So one of the things that I talk to the guys is to make sure if we are working in areas after a storm drain, that we're doing more monitoring of the walls of the excavation, that we're making sure that we have the appropriate protective systems in place, and that we're inspecting the equipment as well. Another thing right outside of the space, you know, with the weather like this, is just the trip hazards, slips and trips. It's muddy, it's wet, you know, things like that. So we just gotta be a little bit more aware of the environment when the weather's like this. Good morning.
All right, we'll holler at you later.
What's up, howdy?
What's up?
I seen you before. I saw you on the road this morning.
Long time no see.
What's up?
How's it going?
Good, good. No work today, huh? With the weather?
Rained out. It's sunny Arizona.
Yeah, I know. Crazy.
I know. Some guys crazy from Texas may have brought some weather with them.
I know, they did, I think. So.
Well, actually, it's headed their way.
Yeah.
So when they go home, they'll get it. Right?
Cool.
Yeah, you picked the worst week.
I know. It's the damn Nino, you know?
Yeah.
So, cool. Yeah. Anyways, they're going to spend some time here with you guys.
Okay,
is that cool?
That's fine. Absolutely.
You too?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll be here for a little bit.
Okay.
So. I've got Hugo coming in.
Yeah.
He doesn't know. He's going to walk into this and be like, oh, my God.
Okay.
He might run away.
All right. We just, I had a meeting here with our project team, just kind of, with the weather right now, they weren't really working. And, so just kind of wanted to get an update as to where we're at and what's going on here. So we're able to see what's upcoming work. Days, there's obviously no work. Tomorrow, they're probably, with the weather, I don't think there's going to be any work. And the reason why this affects them so much is because they're doing the roadway, and they have to grade and make sure that the roads are all nice and level. And when it's raining like that, it really messes up with that process, so they really can't work. It becomes too muddy, and you can't grade anything, and so that's why they're not working today. But we are going to another job site that's just down the street, and what they're doing there is a job that we picked up from the city of Tempe from another contractor that was doing that work. Everything's critical, and we have to get it done. But if there's conditions that it's creating a very serious hazard, and it's not safe, and the equipment is sliding back and forth, and it's just, you know, even though we have a critical job to do, you know, the best thing to do at times is stop the job, and that's what we'll do. You know, we couldn't work under these conditions. It's going to cause an issue. It's going to cause an accident. So extreme unsafe conditions, we're definitely going to stop the work. This job here is a job that Achen-Gardner picked up because there's a contractor prior to us that was contracting through the city of Tempe that was supposed to be installing some water lines and services, and they had a lot of issues with their quality of work and a lot of issues with safety. And because of the reputation that we have and the relationships that we have with Tempe, they were able to call us and say, hey, we need you guys to come in and make things better and help us out with it and do it right. And so we stepped out, and this is not a job that we bid for. It's a job that was handed to us based on our reputation and based on the work that we do. So right now what we're doing basically is going back and repairing and replacing some of the installations that were done by the prior contractor. And so we're here today we're doing a tie-in, one of the final parts of it. So we're doing a tie-in here. How long have you guys been draining now?
For over an hour.
Oh, okay, so you guys just started.
Yeah.
Well, how long is it gonna take how long will it take for it to completely drain?
We're wondering if we gotta call the city back out and get another valve. We just checked their hydrant that they got open, but it's still draining out over there.
Because it's still flowing pretty good though. I mean, and there's still pressure there, you know?
Right, so. We've got this hydrant open. There's water coming out of it.
Yeah.
But that's a big problem out here with all the valves.
Yeah.
They don't have enough shutdown power.
Come on over here. So, you know, one of the things that we're looking at here and some of the hazards that we have here too, just based on the environment and, you know, I already talked about the electrical hazards. We're dealing with electrical power. We're dealing with tools and equipment and they're plugging them into the generator. So one of the things that we're looking at is that. But another big safety hazard is when we're getting ready to cut out these lines, they're under pressure, so they just kind of scar it and reduce the pressure from the lines as the water drains. And talking to Omar here, he's our foreman, he was saying that the city might have to come back out and maybe relook at some of the valves that they have to shut down because they've only been draining for about an hour and there's still a lot of pressure. So that's a concern for him and for his guys because again, the weather's one thing and now adding more water into the trench becomes more of a hazard. So that's what we're looking at now. You can see where they cut that line. And some of the hazards with that, when they're cutting that line, you know, if it is pressurized and they don't drain it or reduce the pressure as they're cutting it, it can break, it can snap and explode on the guy. So that's a big hazard. So a lot of it has to do with the planning that Omar does with his guys. And the city really coordinating with the city water department to make sure that the valves are off. And so right now they've been draining for an hour, and the shutoffs were located about a mile away from here,
half a mile that way,
a quarter mile up that street there. So this is critical, and this stage that we're in is critical, right? We're doing a tie-in. We're going to be doing a tie-in here. We're scheduled to do this in a couple days, right?
Yes, we have to finish this one so I can work on the other one, but we've got to get it done by the end of January.
So here with the weather, here in Arizona, it doesn't rain a whole lot, but when it does rain, we typically shut down the jobs. But this particular job, we have guys that are working, and obviously we did some planning, and so they're all geared up with their raincoats and try to keep them dry. But you know, will there become a point where it becomes too dangerous that you say, you know what, let's just stop, or it becomes too much of a risk, even though we have a critical job to do?
We're kind of at the point of no return now because we've already cut into the pipes.
Right.
We have to do something now. And we can't just put a Band-Aid on it.
Right, we're
committed now.
Okay, so there's no way to stop that. I mean, there's just no, we have to finish it now.
And then we'll have to hold up and wait for a minute to let the weather pass. I was looking at the weather channel. The radar showing a big cell, but it's supposed to clear up.
We got to inspect our tools every day. Every day we have to inspect them. But today is very, very important that we really inspect them, because if we have an extension cord that's not properly inspected or it's cut and it's running through a mud or some water, it can get into the electricity and it can get into the extension cord and became an electrical hazard. So another option that these guys have, I was talking to Tony, he was telling me that they're using air-powered tools instead of electrical tools. So that eliminates that electrical hazard, which is good, and that's part of the process and that's part of the training and part of the planning that we do.